All right, before we go to a special report on the fire that took place, we'd like to play out for you something extremely poignant, extremely tragic. It is the audio clip of one of those men who was killed in the fire, Musharraf Ali, who was from Bijnor. He called up his family as the fire broke out in the factory. He has three daughters and one son. He'd been working at the factory for 4 years. Just listen in to his last call.
अब देखो घर का अब भैया ध्यान नहीं दे रहे
अब मेरे भाई
ठीक है तू ही का भैया अब देखो
वो सिंपल
हां भैया साथ भी नहीं दे रहे मुन्नू अब साथ भी नहीं दे रहे यार
आप कैसे लगी
पता नहीं दे
मतलब ओ
ये अल्लाह देखो तो भैया साथ कर यार और भी जगह डाल लाए कई सारे है जी
को निकलना कई बात नहीं फायर ब्रिगेड को फोन करता
नहीं कुछ नहीं हो रहा
Now, the Delhi police has arrested the owner of the building, Mohammed Rehan, and his manager, and in connection with this massive fire that broke out in which 43 people have been killed. Now, the incident which took place in the early morning, the fire breaking out at 5 in the morning, is the second biggest fire accident that we've seen in Delhi since the Uphaar cinema case, the Uphaar tragedy in 1997, in which 59 lives were lost. The Delhi Fire Service has declared that the building did not have a fire clearance and that no fire safety equipment was even found on the premises. While the preliminary cause is said to be a short circuit, further probe is being done into the matter by the Delhi Police Special Branch. Also, the Delhi Chief Minister has announced a magisterial inquiry. More than 40 lives lost and over 20 injured in a factory fire in North Delhi's Anaj Mandi area. The second biggest fire Delhi has ever seen since the Uphaar cinema tragedy in 1997, which left 59 dead. The fire started around 5 in the morning in a four-story building where paper printing, plastic toys and bag-making workshops are run. Over 100 workers were asleep inside when the fire broke out. Fire tenders reached the area 20 minutes after the fire broke out, but then struggled to get through the narrow lane. Gas cutters were used to cut through windows and rescue people.
Prima facie हमें लग रहा है कि ये short circuit से आग लगी है। ये जो plastic का material है, इससे smoke वगैरह काफी बन गया। और जो deaths भी हुई हैं, जो unfortunate deaths हुई हैं, वो ज़्यादा asphyxia से, suffocation से हुई हैं। Fire tender के भी दो जो कर्मचारी हैं, उनको थोड़ी चोट आई है, दो पुलिस वालों को भी चोट आई है।
हमने जो इसके एक one of the owners रेहान था, उसको arrest कर लिया। उनका एक manager था, जो कि उनके behalf पे काफी कुछ काम देखता था इस बिल्डिंग से रिलेटेड फुरकान को भी अरेस्ट कर लिया है इसके अलावा बाकी जिन जिन को आगे रेंट पे दिया हुआ था और डिफरेंट फैक्ट्रीज चला रहे थे उनको हम लोग सर्च कर रहे हैं
हमारी पूरी कोशिश है कि जो इंजर्ड हैं उनको किसी भी तरह से बचाया जाए सरकार ने मैजिस्ट्रियल इंक्वायरी ऑर्डर कर दी है और जितने भी लोगों की मौत हुई है उनको सरकार 10-10 लाख रुपए का मुआवजा देगी और 1-1 लाख रुपए इंजर्ड को मुआवजा देगी
According to the Delhi Fire Service, the building did not have any fire clearance and no fire safety equipment was found on the premises. The Delhi police have detained and registered a case against the building owner, Mohammed Rehan. Residents and other workshop owners in the area claim that most lack legal permits.
सब ये बिहारी रूपी से आए हुए हैं ये काम करने मजदूरी करते हैं किराए पे मकान लेके करते हैं
और वही काम करते
हैं हां वही 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 सोते हैं रात वही वही सोते हैं रात में
अच्छा तो ये लीगल परमिट वगैरह है ये सब अंदर जितनी फैक्ट्रियां हैं उनके पास
परमिट नहीं है
कोई फायर इक्विपमेंट वगैरह अंदर रहता है जो फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर के कैन होते हैं और वो सब
ये कुछ भी नहीं अंदर
तो यहां पे लीगल परमिट होता है
जी नहीं मैडम ऐसा किसी के पास ऐसा है नहीं
बिल्कुल कभी कोई किसी म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन दिल्ली पुलिस कभी कोई आती है इंस्पेक्शन करने पूछती है कि आप लोग कैसे यहां पे चला रहे
हैं फायर मशीन लेकर लगा के गई है कई फैक्ट्रियों के अंदर जो है ना जैसे कि हमने भी लगवा रखी है अपने फैक्ट्री के अंदर
और जहां पे घटना हुई है जहां पे आग लगी है वहां पर थे इस तरह के फायर सेफ्टी के इक्विपमेंट थे वहां पर
भाई रिहान के ग्राउंड फ्लोर पे मैंने देखा है जी उनके नीचे लगा हुआ था
द बीजेपी एंड आम आदमी पार्टी हैव ब्लेम्ड ईच अदर फॉर द वायलेशन ऑफ रूल्स
मैं नहीं समझता कि सरकार कुछ कर रही है इस बारे में इंक्वायरी होती है जांच होती है बस उस फिर मामला खत्म हो जाता है कोई ध्यान नहीं दे रहा है तो मैं समझता हूं सरकार को इसको दिल्ली सरकार को इस पर ध्यान देना चाहिए
अगर एक घर के अंदर अवैध तरीके से फैक्ट्री चल रही थी तो उसको बंद कराने की जिम्मेदारी एमसीडी की है भाजपा जहां पर शासन करती है।
ट्रेडर्स बॉडीज इन द एरिया ब्लेम द गवर्नमेंट फॉर नॉट फोकसिंग ऑन रीडेवलपमेंट।
पुरानी दिल्ली में 5% भी हमारे सदर बाजार के ऊपर गवर्नमेंट खर्च नहीं करती। अभी आप सदर बाजार की गलियां देखें, सदर बाजार की मार्केटें देखें, इतनी कंजेस्टेड है कि अगर दिन में ये हादसा होता तो मेरे ख्याल से सैकड़ों लोग तो कुचल कर मर जाते।
Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced a compensation of 2 lakh to the families of the deceased and 50,000 rupees to the families of the injured. The Prime Minister also tweeted, "The fire in Delhi's Anaj Mandi on Rani Jhansi Road is extremely horrific. My thoughts are with those who've lost their loved ones. Wishing the injured a quick recovery, authorities are providing all possible assistance at the site of the tragedy."
Political parties are once again blaming each other and there is no accountability in sight. But for the families of those who lost their lives in a fire that engulfed them while they were still asleep, there are no answers at the moment. With camera person Sushil Rathi, this is Sukirti Dwivedi for NDTV.
Now after the fire, the victims were taken to the LNJP, the Lady Harding and the RML hospitals. Family members from UP and Bihar were still trying to make their way while friends and colleagues had a harrowing time looking for their dear ones in the hospitals. Ruksana Khartoon from Motihari in Bihar woke up to the shocking news that her brothers were sleeping in the building that caught fire early this morning. By the time she arrived at the LNJP hospital, her worst fears were confirmed. Both her brothers, laborers in the factory aged 19 and 27, were dead. Most of the deaths were due to suffocation in the smoke. While relatives, who are mostly in UP and Bihar villages, are yet to reach, friends of those who were in the factory are looking desperately.
नहीं मिल रहे ना, तो उसी के लिए हम लोग हॉस्पिटल तलाश रहे हैं कि कौन है कौन नहीं है।
अभी यहाँ या अंदर भी नहीं जाने दिया जा,
अभी नहीं दे पाएंगे।
अंदर भी जाने नहीं दिया जा रहा है, जो कि हम लोग अपने साथियों को, अपने दोस्तों को जाकर देख सकें कि यहाँ कौन मौजूद है, यहाँ कौन मौजूद नहीं है।
Vaseem was looking for his two friends who worked at the factory for 70 rupees a day. They had planned to play cricket later on the day of the fire. Now they are missing.
Cricket वगैरह खेलते थे ना, तो इस वजह से वो संतनगर बुराड़ी से आया था हम लोगों के साथ खेलने के लिए। तो शनिवार के रात में आया था, वो वही सो रहा था।
तो आप तलाशते हुए यहाँ पे आए हुए हैं पता करने के लिए कि क्या हाल है इनका, लेकिन अंदर नहीं जाने दिया जा रहा है।
जी।
आपके मम्मी ने भी थोड़ी देर पहले आपको कॉल किया, वो भी क्या
जी, बहुत वो भी पूछ रही थी कि क्या हुआ है उनका बताओ।
Inside the hospital's emergency ward, these 9 survivors are being treated, including the valiant fireman Rajesh Shukla, who saved 11 lives.
This is the worst incident of fire in the city of Delhi since Bhavana last year, when 17 laborers had died. Though the official figures say that 43 people have lost their lives, but friends, family and neighbors say that there could be many, many more, and many bodies are charred beyond recognition. In New Delhi, with cameraperson Xavier Thomas, this is Rika Roy for NDTV.
Now, the number of dead in that massive fire in Delhi could have been much higher had Rajesh Shukla, a firefighter, waited for backup before he entered the building. Mr. Shukla, who's one of the first firemen to enter the building in North Delhi's Anaj Mandi, actually saved 11 people from the fire that engulfed the factory. He was injured during the rescue operation. Several firefighters were seen carrying unconscious laborers on their backs. But there you can see the visual of Mr. Satyendra Jain meeting with that fireman, the hero really, who rescued 11 people. Well, let's now go across to our panelists to talk about once again a fire tragedy in the national capital. We're joined by GC Mishra, former director, Delhi Fire Services. From the Aam Aadmi Party, we have Saurabh Bhardwaj. From the Congress, Alka Lamba. From the Shiromani Akali Dal, MLA Manjinder Singh Sirsa is joining us. And Neelam Krishnamurthy, somebody who lost her children in the Uphaar tragedy. And I'd like to start with you, Neelam. I'm sorry, because every time, you know, we have this fire tragedy incident, I do know that we always call you in to talk about it. I feel we, you know, make you relive what you went through in the Uphaar case. But just for our viewers, so that they know that you have turned into something of a crusader when it comes to fire safety. So once again, when we see a tragedy like this taking place, a blame game has broken out between the BJP and Aam Aadmi Party. What do you have to say on this fire tragedy in Delhi?
First of all, like this, I'm very anguished. Each time I see a fire incident, of course, you're right. There's a lot of echo. Can you please correct it? There's a
all
lot
right,
of
ma'am,
echo.
We'll just look into that. Do go ahead. Yes.
Yeah. So what I feel, and first of all, I like to tell these politicians not to politicize this. They should be ashamed of themselves. There are 43 people who have died. They cannot be playing politics over the dead body. We all know there are elections around the corner, but I don't think they should do that if they have any shame at all. That's the first thing I like to say. So I request these panelists who are sitting here not to politicize, not to do any blame game. Number two, I think the government is not interested. The only thing that has changed from Uphaar and now is, when Uphaar, when the victims died, the government had announced 50,000 as compensation and the Prime Minister had given 50,000. Now it's gone up to 10 lakh and 2 lakh, right? Otherwise, do you think they are bothered that people are dying? For them, they only vote banks, because ordinary people are dying in the fire incidents. All that they need to do is, they should let the policy makers sit there and decide to make policy decisions when they are regularizing illegal colonies. When these illegal buildings are coming up, what is the MCD doing? When they are running commercial activities from the residential buildings, what are these authorities doing? It can be MCD, it can be DFS, it can be the licensing or any other department. So what needs to be done right now is not to do the blame game, but to sit and see. Where all have they failed? Not just at one place, they failed at every sphere. Who are the people responsible? Dismiss them. Don't just suspend them. And set your system in place. That is what is the need of the hour. We don't want to listen to these politicians telling each other they're responsible, they're responsible. We all know MCD is the most corrupt department. That is from where the entire thing started. Why was this building allowed to come up when it had sanction of 2 floors and you're letting them have 5 floors? So right, we need to do a groundwork
right here.
Ma'am. And
before I go to the politicians, I'd like to go across to Mr. Mishra as the former director of the Delhi Fire Services. And again, in this blame game that's broken out, sir, according to you, who is responsible to ensure such illegal factories are not existing and working? There are many more such factories that are working in that very, very congested North Delhi area.
Yeah, you are right. And this is one case that has suffered the way, which is very painful. But it's the case with the whole of Delhi. Now the areas, except the Lutyen Jones, in all the areas of Delhi, we have settlements which are from dates, say 50s or 60s, and in those period there was no fire law, and the new laws, they are applied prospectively. So Delhi Fire Service, or for that matter any authority, is not vested with the authority to stop the use of the premises. But the only problem is that there is a change of use of the premises. Now, as rightly said by Mrs. Murthy, that this building is a residential building, and there is no question that it should be used for any purpose other than the residential purposes. Now, the fire protection requirement, they are, say, 80% of the requirements are structural in nature. Now, when you change the use of the building, then it becomes unfit for the other occupancy which you press into that.
All right, well, let's go across to Maninder Sirsa, sir. What would you have to say on, you know, what's being said right now on who is responsible for allowing a factory to function in a residential area in this four-story building where, you know, all these activities were taking place, and, you know, the MCD is responsible to ensure that illegalities aren't being carried out?
Not just MCD, it's the Delhi government's Department of Industries who is responsible for that, because they are supposed to give them alternative plot. Now the problem here is as the gentleman Mr. Mishra ji
but Mishra
well very said
plot is that is it's a not about matter, North Delhi only,
it's in the entire Delhi these factories are running.
Yeah, that this
will,
factory
will
was
please,
actually
will
running.
You, will you please let me complete my sentence?
Sure, go ahead.
If you let me complete, then
go
you
ahead, go ahead, sir.
Yeah, that's true. That is the problem. That is the problem. That is the problem. The factory is running. Now, the question is, the MCD has not issued a license. That's right. MCD has not issued any license to run this factory. Then, who are supposed to turn these illegal factories to the legal premises? That is Delhi government. That's the Department of Industries in Delhi. They were supposed to shift this industry to Bhavana. The alternative plots were given for in Bhavana. They are the one who are supposed to get this industry shifted to Bhavana. If they not got alternative plot, then they must give them alternative plot and making sure that this legal industry is legalized in the legal premises. Now the problem here is neither they got the alternative plots, neither they got shifted out of this place. Then who? There is a proper industry department in government of Delhi. I do understand that whenever it comes to politicians, you have to blame each other. But the fact of the matter is, Delhi government has a Department of Industries and there is an industry minister in Delhi. Then what is the job of industry minister?
All right, so let's take that across to Saurabh. Saurabh, go ahead.
It is sole responsibility to ensure that there is ever illegal industry.
When he says that it's the responsibility of the government, and we do have many factories in Delhi, and yes, those have to be shifted out to areas. And even when we talk about air pollution, etc., we do need to shift these factories out. And of course, the danger, pose to localities like this.
I think we have to understand it very systematically, and it's not a very complicated thing. It's a very easy thing. Look, there are 2-3 agencies which are involved. One is MCD, one is Delhi Fire Service, third is Industries Department. Okay. Now, all the land use across Delhi is a designated land use. Either it is a residential area, or it is a mixed use, or it is a commercial area. Okay. Now, any land use, if it is a residential area and you bring up a factory there, or if you start commercially using the space, it is the MCD and the Delhi police which will take cognizance of the fact and seal the premises. Okay. And if they say no, we want a license or we want to run a legal factory here, then they will apply for license to the industrial department and then they will eventually go to fire department. But this is a completely illegal factory which is running. So basically, it should have come and it was in the cognizance of MCD that, you know, they should have sealed the premises. Now, coming up to the question of alternative plots, there are almost 50,000 alternative plots which have been provided to the factories. And the list of all those factories who have been provided alternative plots is also given to MCD 2 years back. And MCD is supposed to take action against them. And MCD is not even taking action against those who have been provided.
Mr. Sisa is saying the government needed to have taken action. Yes. You are saying it's the MCD that needed to have taken action.
Look, industrial department will only come into
play
if
it's a hot potato, political hot potato in terms of shifting people out, because there also you have local resistance.
Anybody, you bring a, you bring a MCD commissioner on record and she will tell you the truth. Here you have an officer who is telling you on record. Look, politician can say anything. You ask an MCD officer what is truth, they will tell you.
All right, Mr. Sisa, just a moment. Let me go across to Alka as well, because let's face it, this Delhi, the mess that we're seeing is not an immediate, you know, the result of something immediate. This is decades and decades of the way Delhi has grown and been mismanaged. We have these Lal Dora areas. We have these areas that, you know, haven't come under the ambit of the law as such. As you can see here, MCD, you know, somebody saying MCD is responsible, Delhi government is responsible. Alka, what would you say on this tragedy that's taken place?
देखिए, मैं इसको पॉलिटिसाइज नहीं करूंगी. जैसे मैम ने कहा है, अगर बीजेपी और आम आदमी पार्टी, जिसकी नगर निगम दिल्ली में सरकार है, अगर जिम्मेदारी नहीं लेती, पॉलिटिसाइजिंग नहीं करना, तो डाल दीजिए हम लोगों पर जिम्मेदारी, हम ले लेंगे इसकी जिम्मेदारी. लेकिन अकाउंटेबिलिटी, अकाउंटेबिलिटी मैडम ने सही कहा, करप्शन सबसे बड़ा कारण है. क्योंकि दोनों विधायक जो हैं, आम आदमी पार्टी बीजेपी के, एक साउथ से आते हैं, एक वेस्ट से आते हैं. मैं उसी पुरानी दिल्ली 6 से आती हूं जहां ये घटना हुई है. सबसे बड़ी घटना 1997 में उपहार कांड थी, और उसके बाद जब कांग्रेस की गवर्नमेंट आई, 22 साल तक कोई बहुत बड़ा हादसा नहीं हुआ. लेकिन उसके बाद लगातार 2018 का 20 जनवरी को 17 जाने गई, 2018 का केस है. करोल बाग में 4 जाने गई, 2018 का मामला है. ओखला में 5 जाने जाती है, 2019 का मामला है. 8 दिसंबर को आज 43 जाने जाती हैं, 2019. अगर आप 18 और 19 बड़ी फायर जिसमें ट्रेजेडी बड़ी हुई जाने गई, वो 18 और 19 के हैं. जवाबदेही इन दोनों की नहीं है. मैडम ने सही कहा करप्शन. आम आदमी पार्टी का पहला मंत्री लैंड में बिल्डर से पैसे लेने में स्ट्रिंग में पकड़ा गया अरविंद केजरीवाल जी ने, बाहर कर दिया। दूसरे जो मंत्री आए उनका भी स्ट्रिंग आ गया है कि बिल्डिंग जो बन रही है, बिल्डर माफिया नक्शे को नियमों को ताक में रखकर बना रहे हैं, उगाइयां हो रही हैं, कार्रवाइयां नहीं हो रही। करोल बाग में जो घटना होटल में हुई, सिनेमा हॉल, उपहार सिनेमा हॉल से करोल बाग के आप होटल से लेकर यहां तक आ जाइए, कार्रवाइयां नहीं हो रही, एक दूसरे के ऊपर डाला जा रहा है, फायर क्लियरेंस नहीं था। और सबसे बड़ी बात, आज जब मैंने फायर के बाराखंबा ऑफिस में फोन किया, क्योंकि मेरी कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी नजदीक में है, और मैंने कहा हम कोई मदद कर सकते हैं, बाराखंबा फोन किया, दे सर अलका जी मदद ये करिए, हमें ऑटो में बिठाकर निजी वाहनों को लोगों को रोककर हमारे जो घायल हैं उन्हें अस्पताल पहुंचाना पड़ा है, एम्बुलेंस की व्यवस्था कर दीजिए। एम्बुलेंस नहीं थी, एक एम्बुलेंस थी मुख्यमंत्री के आवास के बाहर खड़ी थी, और निवेदन किया, हाथ जोड़कर वीडियो भेजा, मैसेज किया, अरविंद जी प्लीज उस एम्बुलेंस को जो वीवीआईपी के लिए रवाना कर दीजिए, कम से कम कुछ लोग बच पाएंगे। तो ये सब जवाबदेही किसकी है? फायर क्लियरेंस नहीं था, बिल्डिंगों में करप्शन है, मोटा माल चुनावी चंदन बिल्डर से आ, सब जानते हैं, लेकिन जवाब दे अगर ये दोनों नहीं लेते, डाल दीजिए हम पर और जनता पर, हम ले लेंगे।
सौरभ, आई थिंक इट इज अ वेरी, मतलब देयर इज नो कॉम्प्लिकेशन एट ऑल। लुक, फायर क्लियरेंस विल ओनली कम इफ समबडी अप्लाइज फॉर एन इंडस्ट्रियल लाइसेंस, यू कैनॉट हैव एन इंडस्ट्री देयर, एंड इट इज ओनली एमसीडी विच हैड टू यू नो stop that building when it was two floor building, and it was the MCD which had have sealed the premises when they come to know that there is a commercial activity or there is a factory running. It is very clear, you know, I don't know how somebody can manipulate it. And the third thing is, you know, talking about, you know, ambulances and all, these are all, you know, very frivolous things to
okay,
say.
Let me show you the video. Right. Are you ready to see the video?
I got the issue.
It's a live video from morning. ki mukhyamantri ke ghar ke bahar ambulance hai.
And oh, all that would remain. But Neelam Krishna Murthy would like to come back. Let me go back to Neelam ji.
Shame, man.
Neelam Krishna Murthy.
Every chief minister is having.
What would you say? You've been hearing this discussion. You heard what Saurabh had to say, that it's the MCD that was responsible in ensuring this building didn't rise, you know, over two stories. And Mr. Sinha, they're saying that it's the industries, you know, ministry that should have made sure that these factories were shifted out to plots outside. Let's face it, this is a political hot potato, this issue of, you know, it comes into livelihood, people will resist, you know, politicians will jump into the mix if any action is taken and factories shifted out.
Well, first of all, I'll say hamam mein sab nange hain. That each one of them are to be blamed equally. It's just not BJP, Congress or Aam Aadmi Party. Each one of them have failed the citizens of Delhi. That is the point. They failed to perform their duties. They have failed to take corrective measures and to come to the rescue of these people who died. Why weren't the ambulances provided? Why weren't the clearances given in time? Why don't they put their house in order? These are some important issues. They have all failed miserably. Why can't they come here on the television channels and accept, yes, we have failed. Let's sit down together and see what needs to be done, where we can improvise. That's one thing nobody is willing to do, because they are only interested in one thing, that they should get their votes. That's all. They should come to power and rule the state. That's all that they are interested in.
All right. Well, your governments and your parties are responsible. One is MCD, one is Delhi government. Can we have an audit then of these sort of illegal factories that are obviously existing in various parts of Delhi that are future, you know, fire traps or dangerous to the citizens, Mr. Sisa? What would you say to that?
Gargi, it is simply impossible to say this thing ki wo Delhi ki sarkar ki bina kisi tarike bhi industry shift ho sakti. That is simply impossible. Now, if Saurabh Bhardwaj is sitting on a national channel, I must ask him a very simple question. Is he ready to provide, koi aisi list hume provide kar sakte hain ki Delhi ki ye sari industry seal karo is area mein? I'm ready to do that. Saurabh Bhardwaj should come out and say ki dekhiye ye Delhi ki illegal industry hai aur hum isko seal karna chahte hain. Hum ye list unko provide karein, seal karein. I take a responsibility as a alliance partner to the BJP. आप लिस्ट प्रोवाइड करें, आप उनको ऑल्टरनेटिव प्लॉट नहीं प्रोवाइड कर पा रहे, आप उनको ऑल्टरनेटिव जगह नहीं प्रोवाइड कर पा रहे, दिस इज द ओनली सॉल्यूशन कि हम जगह भी देंगे, प्लॉट भी देंगे, इंडस्ट्री भी बनाएंगे और सील करेंगे। यू कम आउट ऑफ द लिस्ट,
दीजिए
आप लिस्ट, दीजिए, यू गिव अस अ प्रोवाइड अस अ लिस्ट। ये सारी
इंडस्ट्री वाला बात कर रही हूं, एमएलए रही हूं, इन्होंने कभी लिस्ट नहीं दी और वो इस लिस्ट के इंतजार में रहे। दोनों ने
लेट सौरभ आंसर को, आई थिंक इट इज फेयर स्टुपिडिटी टू टॉक लाइक दिस। The list has been provided on the orders of High Court, not today, 2 years back. They have the list. Each municipal councillor is minting money out of that list. Everybody is given a notice and after the notice you mint money from them and you don't seal it. He knows it. He was a counselor himself.
All right, well, I think the blame game is continuing. He was a counselor himself. Clearly, we need answers from authorities and not this passing of the buck when it comes to a tragedy that's happened today, the second worst fire incident in Delhi in which 43 lives have been lost. Thank you all for joining me today. Good night.